Hey everybody, what's up? It is Tuesday, October 15th. Nice rally in the stock market today. As I said in my last video, I had a last week on Friday when the Fed came out with that, again, another one of these surprise announcements. They're going to be buying $60 billion a month in treasuries, and they're going to extend the term repos and all this other stuff, this extension of this liquidity provision. I had to think about it. And I came to the conclusion after looking at the numbers and looking at the data and analyzing their statement, which it was pretty straightforward. I mean, they said they wanted to keep reserve balances at levels equal to where they were in early September. So let's say we're going to round it off to $1.5 trillion. That's good. I mean, if that is their intention, and that's what they said, and if they keep them there steady without this crazy volatility, that's stability, man. And that's bullish. Had to reassess the situation, I said. And as a matter of fact, even going back to not Friday, but last Tuesday, I said to my subscribers, you got to start buying the dips in the stock market. You got to get long. So now we are very close to new all-time record highs. But that's not what I want to talk about here in this video. You know, folks, I have said many times in the past that what we do as traders is very similar to high-level professional athletes, in that it's a very high-level, intense competition. On many levels, actually, and I'll get into that. But we need those same sort of skills. It is a fight. It is a battle. Actually, I have used the analogy of UFC fighters, martial artists, and I think that's a very appropriate analogy. All right. And if you take that analogy, and if you accept that analogy, which I think there's no other really close analogy to what we do as traders, you really have to look at competitive sports, fight sports, that's a great one, or any high-level sport. I mean, if you're a follower, for example, of American football, because that is a great, looking at that as the model. I mean, if you look at who are the consistent winners? Who are the winners? If you look at people like Tom Brady, quarterback of the New England Patriots, if you look at a guy like Russell Wilson, quarterback of the Seattle Seahawks, or anyone who is in that really, really upper echelon, high level of winners, what is the common denominator? What separates them? I mean, there's a lot of really talented quarterbacks on other teams, and I can go down a list. But I mean, what separates guys like Brady and Russell Wilson and Aaron Rodgers, for that matter, what separates them? And, you know, again, you can go to other sports. You know, UFC, Khabib Nurmagomedov, a guy like George St. Pierre. I mean, it is that ability to overcome. The ability to overcome whatever the situation they are in. When they're faced with adversity, and, you know, I like the Tom Brady example right now, for example, or Aaron Rodgers, because if you look at their teams, it's them and it's the rest of the team, but no particular outstanding superstars surrounding them. A bunch of relatively ordinary players compared to players in similar positions on other teams that we might call superstars. But these guys like Aaron Rodgers, guys like Tom Brady, they're able to elevate not only themselves, but the people around them or the tools that they have, whatever they're facing. In other words, let me put it a different way. Whatever their situation, they are able to somehow make use of that and bring it to the highest level. They are able to overcome, that's a better way to put it, they're able to overcome any particular adversity that is thrown at them. They lose their star players around them, they're still able to overcome that handicap. Same thing with trading. In trading, you are thrust into the arena. You are in a competition. It is a battle. It is a battle with who? Not you against the market. The market is your arena. That is where you, you know, carry out your trade. Your opponent are the other people, the other actors, the other traders in the marketplace. And they have a particular way of behaving. They have a particular way of acting in aggregate. It's very easy to understand. Like, I call them the zombies. You know how they are going to react. Now, you can choose to be one of them and go with the crowd like sheep. Or when you do battle with them, when they are your opponent, and you understand their behavior, it is imperative that your behavior be fashioned in such a way as to take advantage of what they are doing. Because this is a zero-sum game. Somebody loses and somebody wins, and you want to be the guy who wins. Now, what I have found is that the mentality of most people, and by the way, this has become so obvious to me since I've been doing the reports and mentoring people and helping people. I mean, I see it. I see the behavior. And I've talked about it so many times here. You've heard me talk about it so many times. People come to me, oh, my MMT, I'm so excited. I can't wait to learn, which is great. That's a great step to want to better yourself, to want to become more informed, to want to educate yourself, to want to raise your level of understanding. That's great. And for many people, to accept MMT takes an open mind. I mean, you see out there right now, when MMT is really starting to go viral, there is so much criticism of it. There are so many who are blocked from accepting it. When all it is really is a definition or an understanding of how an economy works under a floating exchange rate type of a system. But people are blocked. So anyway, they come to me, they're really excited, and they want to, you know, put it into action, because I tell them, like, I'm the only guy, right, who has applied MMT. And then what happens? They run into adversity. They run into some frustration, maybe some losses on paper. Maybe things are taking longer than they want, right? You can't be needy, right? I want this to happen now. I need this to happen now. So then that self-destructive behavior starts to well up and take control of them again, and it leads to the same pattern of self-sabotage that they were on prior to coming here. How do I know? I went through this for many, many years myself, personally. It's so obvious. The ones who make it, and when I'm talking about make it, I'm talking about they come to a place of not only understanding, but of self-management, where, I'll give you an example. I say to people, how many times have you been in this situation? You've been in a situation where you have a profitable trade and then it goes against you, and that is like a terrible feeling, a horrible feeling. That's how most people relate to that. Oh, why didn't I take the profit? See, that, and then sometimes they take the profit very quick and then it keeps on going, and they'd say, well, why didn't I stay in there longer? So you see, that is a problem of thinking. That is a problem of framing in the mind what is happening to you. When the real way to handle a situation like that is to say, it's great. I want to get into a trade that is making a profit and then it goes against me. I want to, that frees you. That liberates you. The more you can do that and embrace that mentality and look at it and frame it in that mentality, you are liberated to literally making unlimited amounts of money in the markets. Most people don't do that. They trade with fear. They trade tight. Tight. Like even pulling the trigger, like everything's got to be so aligned for them. Like you see the comments here a lot of times, like, oh, you didn't get the exact bottom or you didn't get the exact top. Like they're trading tight. Like any athlete, you can't trade, you can't be tight. You got to be loose. You got to be able to flow. I say, get in, pull the trigger, get in and hope that it goes against you. Like really, that is a blessing. There's nothing better than that when it happens, and to be able to work through that, man, that gives you ultimate, not just confidence, but control over your own outcome. How many times have I said the market can do nothing to you? You do whatever it is you do to yourself. Anyway, sign up. Go to pitbulleconomics.com. Sign up for a 30-day free trial of MMT Trader. See you. Bye-bye.